I put makeup and I got dressed because I'm about to film a sit-down video, and I thought, why not start the introduction for a new vlog? I'm not sure how much I will get done this week, but I'll try to vlog more of like what I'm up to during the week. And also, I wanted to unbox with you my new, is it called statement chair, I think. And it just arrived. There is that box there, and we're gonna box it together. Also, the plan for renovation wise is to get my office ready. Here is the state of my office now. If the camera will decide to focus, I still got boxes. And the poor little plant that seems to actually thrive there in the corner since has been forgotten. Why are the plants thriving when they are forgotten? I'm not sure, but that's what we're working with. There are lots of things that the boxes are like half empty, and we need to sort out the under stairs here so I can have a little bit more storage. The problem is we've got this thing in here, and I can't really do much about it. We cannot move it. I thought maybe I can put some of those, you know, like metal rails that then you can add brackets and put the shelves on. I think that's a B&Q has them, so I will have a look in there. For now, we just added some hooks for the jackets, but there's a lot of wasted space. Also because this is like the shelter, and I'm not sure how to use the space now. So switching this off, and in here, I got some boxes out and I changed the curtain. It doesn't look the best, it's just because when you come to the house, this is a front window and it looked horrible with the old curtains. And I just attached them to this old pole rail thing, which is gonna go as well. There is a lot to do. Let's see how much I can get done this week, but for now, let's open this. The aftermath of my haul videos, and the man is doing the chair. I love this green color, it's so beautiful, because our sofa is gonna be a tan, more like an orangey tan, and with deep green, it's gonna look so lovely. And I want to put the seat there, and then this one, I'm gonna move it somewhere else, or maybe we can keep both, we'll see. Look at the wood. The wood is so nice. I will leave a link to this if anyone wants it, but we bought it on sale, and now I checked the website again because we didn't understand which way this goes, so we needed to look at a photo, and it's back to full price. I think it's 240 full price, but it looks like the wood is a very good quality. and I love the legs, just so sleek and nice. Here is the beauty. Let's do a seat test. Lovely. Comfy? It's comfy. I don't think it's comfy enough to just sit down and watch a full movie because it's quite short here. It's more like a statement chairs for conversation. This is why I got it, because when we have guests over, we have a three-seater, and we have a sofa, again, it's a three-seater, and you can't just sit all in a row and have a conversation. So this is gonna complete our little conversational area for our living room. I'm about to do a hack with my orchids. I have this and another one from, this is from HomeSense, $6.99. I actually filmed the HomeSense haul, and I saw on TikTok, if I can find it again and add it maybe somewhere here, I will do. But basically what it says is, take the orchid, remove all the soil completely, just clean up the roots and put it in one of these with a bit of water, and it looked so good, so much nicer than this plastic see-through pots that I have in here, and this orchid I just rescued from the shop and it needs attention. And you cannot put it in the ceramic pots, you know, the one when you buy orchids, like this one, I don't know, this one is kind of thriving in here, but usually in the ceramic pots like this, they don't like it because the roots need to absorb sun. So most of mine, kind of like all of mine, got another one here which is in this see-through pot, and they look ugly. So I'm gonna try the hack and then I'll show you how it looks like. I'm not gonna do it with all of them, just to make sure that I don't kill my orchids, and then if they thrive, I will try and buy some of these like glass vessel vases and maybe find some in the charity shops and slowly change all of them, because it just looks so cute and you just have to change the water once a week. So let's just do this. Situation at the moment, this one is here and has a lot of roots. I probably still need to check how many roots they need to have and if I need to trim some more. Yeah. And then this one, it was the one I rescued from the shop, it was dying. And these are as many roots as I could save. Everything else was completely dead, and I put it in this IKEA glass to give it, you know, I don't know. We'll see what's going on. Then I have this one, the same, this was a little rescue. I put it in the cup, it's got a few roots in there. It needs like a see-through cup, which I don't have at the moment. I just have this little teacup. So this one stays there. I mean, she's still gonna get sun through the window inside. Then I have this one, and I realized that I may actually buy some of these like tall jars because it holds the plant up so well. Again, this one has a lot of roots. This is an older one, and I probably need to learn how to take care of the old orchids and the roots. And you can see that my daffodils are already in bloom, which I didn't expect because I wanted to plant them in the garden. But it's too frosty to plant them in the garden. Then in here, I have this one, which doesn't have many roots, but has healthy roots. Again, this one I rescued from Tesco, I think, not long ago. It was on sale, and if you see plants like that and you can rescue them, just give them another life, otherwise they will just go in the bin. So this is where this one lives, and it's just so pretty. Look how cute it looks in here. So yeah, that's my orchid fiasco. I'm not very happy with this one. I don't know, maybe I'll have to change the water and maybe it's gonna be clear. This is one of the very old orchids and I need to trim it a little bit more. I just filmed and their corner is bugging me so much, is bothering me a lot, because there are plenty of wires underneath, which I hate, but I can't really do anything about it. We just need to find something to put there. Now, I was thinking of, by the way, we don't have a Welsh dresser anymore because I sold it online. I just don't have space in the kitchen for it. So I was thinking of moving this back in there. It used to be in the corner before, and now it's in this room. I just dumped it here. So this is my job now. I'm gonna move it there just to cover the wires. And I don't understand what's going on in here. The girls painted on it, and you can see I need to clean it. And that's kind of a finished result. I've got Emilia here. She's sorting out her backpack. I love our new chair. This lamp is on timer. Soon it's gonna go off. This one is already on. And I put this chair here. It feels like it's a nice kind of conversational area where we have one sit here. I really love how everything looks. Their side, and I just love it. Not to praise myself. And I put this room spray in here because it's green and there's no more green in there. On the other side, I put this one. This is from I still need to wipe this. I didn't. This room spray is from Marks & Spencer's. They have this new range. This is Retreat Apothecary. It smells so, so nice. Of like dry wood. I couldn't explain, it just smells of dry wood. It's so nice. And I put my little palm that I forgot about it. I forgot about the existence of this plant, but it kind of thrived in the corner of my overloaded office. This is the best I can do. The router obviously has to be out. Otherwise, there is no internet. I have this little table, side table that I got for free off Marketplace, and it will get a makeover. I need to spray paint it brass. And underneath, I have the aloe vera plant on this little plant stand that I got from Home Sense. The plant, the aloe vera is from IKEA. Yeah. And that's the girls always arguing. So this is how that looks like, and I have a candle and a faux plant in here because this is a bit flimsy and I need to get my husband to screw it properly. But this is after I spray painted, so I can't put anything too heavy. And that's this way. I also hanged this plant that I got from B&M on the wall. If it's like something is still missing, I'm gonna work on it. Maybe a little hanged mirror? I don't know. What is it? You want me to open your banana? I've got a new plant here. She is from Tesco's, I think. And it was only £2.50. Very cheap, very beautiful. And then I love these plant flowers. Now, let me just open it for you. Sorry, baby. Here you go. The flowers are from Tesco again. I bought the flowers when they were completely closed like this, and I had no idea of how beautiful the flowers are open. And the orange one don't smell much, but the white one has such a beautiful smell. And yeah, there is a hairbrush because I brushed my girl's hair this morning. In here is still all basically the same. I kind of like the cloth being there now, so it's gonna be there. It's gonna be yellow. I like the yellow in there. And we are still waiting for our sofa. When the sofa is here, I'm gonna do like a full video about the living room makeover. We are going upstairs to start working on our airing cupboard. Let me just move back. It's a bit too much. Start working on the airing cupboard because the electrician is coming tomorrow to put a light up and a plug as well. I want to put, I need to order it off Amazon, but when the walls are already, my plan is to put an upright like wall mount ironing board, and I'll go Emilia and Taya and have everything there because it's quite big. I was impressed with how big it was. Also, a few more updates that we did. The kitchen needs repainting. Let me just turn you around. The lights in here, if you remember, is this basically, but they are way too powerful. It's not focused now. They are way too powerful. Like in the evening, this, look, this is a full power and sometimes you can get like a headache. We are eating seaweed sheets. We love them. I love it too a lot. And so we got a dimmer and like again 1, 2, 3, 4. This was very expensive. I think it was about £70 for this thing, and we also lost the £30 we paid for the other one, which I really liked, the one with a switch, but we needed a dimmer ball because it's just way too much. So now I can just turn it down and down, and this is all the way down. It's like, you can still see it. It's nice in the evening when we watch TV in there. And here is just a little bit of light. Too dark. Let me switch it on. We also changed the light switches in here. We put the same, the gold one here, and the one upstairs as well. And let me show you the airing cupboard. So here is the airing cupboard. Basically, we have like a little, I don't know how to call this, so the bathroom is that way, and then the airing cupboard is this way. My husband started to dismantle it already, but if I find the footage of how it used to look before, there were some doors here. So my job now is to take all of this out completely so the electrician can work tomorrow. And when I close this door, now I can't. When I take everything out, I'll show you how big it is around. It's quite big. I am going to put more shelves in here for all of the stuff. And in the back, you can't really see much, but I'll show you what the plan is I'll tell you what the plan is after all of this is gone. And like I said, it's dark in here because we don't have any light. Okay, so this is all out. It's so echoey, and I didn't realize we had a hole. It's because there were pipes coming from up from the water tank all the way down. We used to have a big boiler that will heat up the water in here that we removed, hence why there are some pipes that are coming. These are like for heating. I think they are, yeah, they are just here, they are not in use anymore. That's where the boiler used to be. So there's a lot of things to be done in here. So obviously the hole needs to be done, the one in there as well. Yeah, then I just need to take all of this out. You can see where it's already coming out because my husband kind of took the screws out. I just need to bring everything downstairs. And here is the door that used to be here. Also, what's that? I just realized, why is this cut? Like, this is the door frame. So I don't understand what is going on there. And in here, we have a lot of touch-ups to do, so many snags. Something happened downstairs. In here was the thermostat that was removed by the electrician as well. And I need to paint. I need to buy another can of paint of this. And we are gonna fully repaint the kitchen. When it comes to that, I'll tell you. And let me just turn you around. So the reason why we want to fully repaint the kitchen is because the paint that we got is terrible. I do not recommend the Valspal paint. We got the premium one, the most expensive one, and I hate it. Every drop of water will just get soaked in and you leave a mark. Oh my. When every little mark, like, I don't know, the kids will put their hands, and now the electrician needs some more work, and Mommy, there are marks everywhere, and we decided to repaint it with the, yes, lovely? We decided to repaint the whole thing with the little greeny paint, the intelligent mat. Emilia, they're just looking at some, that's the, you remember that? With like the whole family, that's what she's looking at. So we're gonna get the intelligent mat from little greeny because it's so easy to wipe. Just ignore her because she always talks. The little greeny intelligent mat is so easy to wipe. Like this paint here, we had some marks down from the works that have been done after we painted, and we're gonna put it up later when we find the space for it, okay? Yes. And you just take a wet cloth, wipe it, and it's all gone. But the one in the kitchen that is supposed to be this way, because in the kitchen, you know, splashes or fingers or food or anything, is horrible. The paint, I'm sorry to say that, but yeah, it's better to just buy a good one. So that's the plan as well, to when we get to do all the snacks, we're gonna have to repaint the whole kitchen. The updates on the little room, we do have a light now, and in order not to make too many holes in here, because already there are loads, we just had this kind of pull light, the one you usually get in the bathroom, and yeah, just a simple one. I will have to buy a nice shade, and that's how it looks like. My husband fixed the floor, And when my dad is coming, he will put laminate in here, and he will put laminate throughout the upstairs landing. I still need to remove all of this, like, kind of skirting. And my job for today for my husband is to cut this, because it's impossible to remove. Like, this is hard wall. I mean, all the walls in this house, they are all, you can see the like stone wall or bricks. They're ready for me to paint, and I decided to, we have a Kallax from the girls, and I'm gonna put it here, and then we're gonna buy a slimmer one, and that's gonna be our storage, because I think it's gonna work out better than a Billy bookcase. See how it's going? It's just up there left.
That's it?
I mean, not really, that's it, but the skirting is gone. Yay! And I'll show you an update on this room, so as you can see, basically most of the things have been filled up, the hole looks so much better. I was saying I had to turn the camera around, but in there it's almost filled. You have to do it in different parts, and then you will sand it. The hole is almost done. All of this, it's all here. We scraped a little bit of the paint that came off, and I think a little bit more will have to be done. And this room should be ready for painting tomorrow. My husband also started scraping everything by the look of it. And the plan for today is to clean up some toys. And as you can see, the toy room, playroom, is a battlefield. And what I have to do is to clear out as many toys from this Kallax unit as possible and donate them, because I'm gonna use these to put it in the airing cupboard upstairs. Also, it's got paint in there. And this needs to be all clean, and then we're gonna have to, we're gonna buy one for the girls. I think, I don't know, I'm not sure. I was thinking of getting like a single one here for this room only, and some cushions on top so they can sit by the window. But I don't know where we're gonna put the TV. So, okay, this room is gonna get its own makeover, and then I'm gonna think how to set up the playroom. But I need to clear this out. There are a ton of toys that we don't play with, and I need this unit. And I'm done. This is how it looks like. It's so much better. They've got a mini drawer with their arts, like crafting things, pencils, marker, paint. Then their desk, which is not in the best condition because Emilia decided to paint it red, and I just left it like that. In here, I used to have this in the laundry room, so I put it here now because I didn't use it for a long time. So basically, it was just in a corner left. And I've got some like coloring books and all the paper, so they don't go upstairs and bother their daddy to give them paper from the printer. Books in here. And the Lego here, so hoping that they are going to play more with this, because it was kind of put away and they lost interest. And I put the TV on top there, and then in here. I put like my artificial plants in here. I don't know, the windowsill is very narrow, so if I put real plants, they don't sit properly, and my cat likes to climb in here and just look outside or have a nap. We washed these curtains a week ago, and you can see that Mia's fur, because she was sleeping there before I started to hoover. I put here the spare chairs. These are old dining chairs. They look very beaten up. They look dirty. They just don't wash the fabric. I don't know. I tried to wash it and I made it worse and stained it even more. So these are gonna stay here. Probably we'll have to buy some folding chairs so we can store it easier for when the people come, we can just take it out. And in the back here, there is still the little ottoman that I got for free off Marketplace. And it's kind of blocked there. It's still got some toys that I did not sort out because I didn't want to go behind. We are going to move the fishies somewhere else. We don't know where yet. Then on this side, so I had two of these in their room in the other house. I sold one and I kept one because this has some marks and I thought nobody was gonna want it. But it's a good job I kept it because this is the place where the toys live now. So I sorted it out. I put out lots of like little games that they want to play. They got their dressing up princess dresses in here, some other games, and their Barbies. I put it in there. Got a box, it's full of Play-Doh. I had Christmas lights in this box before. Another bin with toys, which I just kept it, and their kitchen. That's pretty much it. I put a little bin in there, and the one is in Thea's little backpack that she brings around. She's got like her precious bits in there, so I just left it there. And I'm so pleased that finally this room is clean. Let's hope it's gonna stay clean like this for a longer time. I'm about to prime the walls in here. The primer I'm using is this one I used before, just a little bit left in here, and I've got another full one. This is great if you have like kind of flaky, maybe old paint on the walls like I have here, and I had in there as well, and it worked perfectly well because it kind of seals everything, and then you just put the paint on top and it doesn't flake or move. It's been a while since we did that in there because we had the horrible green old paint that it wouldn't come with anything, but it was kind of flaky and that worked. And another trick, I'll just turn you around. I got the tray, but I realized I don't have any, you know, the inserts, so I'm just gonna put a plastic bag on top. And I'll have to go to B&Q and buy some inserts. And this is the only roller that I have, which I have no idea where we bought it from or where is the like the actual roller holder that fits this. So what I did is I took one of these, you know, you see that I pulled it out to make it a little bit like kind of thicker. And I'm gonna put this one here and it will hold. I will have to go to B&Q and buy some of these rollers and little inserts for painting the room, because I do have a lot of painting to do. There are still lots of touch-ups in here to be done, so I will need them. And let's just get started. I was talking about flaky paint. This is where it was, and my husband tried to sand it and remove as much as it was kind of coming out. And this is going to be the back. It's going to be covered, so we're not gonna see. In here, he sanded everything and is all ready to be primed and painted. Mm-hmm. It's time to paint. If you see me in this red zip up, it means I'm painting, because I'm not destroying any more clothes. And I also have the Primark leggings that are fully covered in paint. And if you hear Tia, she's just downstairs in her playroom playing. Mommy. What?
It's written mommy, please.
She's making cards. And she said, it's written mommy. And for paint, I'm gonna use my trusted paint that I used before. Show me. You made a card for mommy that's written mommy?
Yes.
Oh, thank you. You're so sweet. I love it. Can you keep it safe for mommy?
Yes.
When I come downstairs, I'm gonna take it, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. So for paint, I'm using this walls and ceiling durable brilliant white from Good Home, which is B&Q matte, and I used it before. It's quite thick, it's very good. I don't know if I'll need two coats, probably, because it's kind of patchy. So let's just do the first coat, and you can see it's a bit shining. I don't know if it's in the camera, the light is reflected, because I put the primer yesterday and everything should stick now. That's the first layer of paint, first coat of paint done. Definitely we'll need another one at least. We'll see how it goes after the second layer, because you can still see the patches and everything. So, oh, I'll wait for this to dry. Unfortunately, this window doesn't open and I can't open for it to dry. Emilia, get out of there, please. For it to dry, and I'll have to wait until tomorrow. And here is a somehow kind of finished look. It's not finished, but I just want to finish this vlog, otherwise it will be too long. And I can't believe how big this room looks, like, because it's all white. I put that there, but we're gonna buy a wall-mounted one, which will go here. I will do like a full reveal one day when everything is ready. This one holds up so much. It's so, I don't know. I just had like a light bulb moment when I thought I could use this here. And I love it because folding towels in the Pinterest way can be time consuming, which I don't have time. And I don't like spending time on making things perfect. So I've got here my bath towels. Like medium towels, these are hand towels, and I'm gonna put here like the face ones because we are all dirty at the moment. Then some curtains, extras, these are empty. In here I just put this sewing kit, and this is my stuff. Then I've got our bed sheets and the kids' bed sheets. And if you hear the kids, we are fighting who needs to clean up downstairs because they made a mess with the toys. And I want to get another Kallax here, the single one. It will fit perfectly, the whole gap. And I've got two baskets to go on top. Also painted the white in here. I like the little light shade. This was only £5 from B&Q. And on this side, I painted that little piece of wood that was holding the hooks. You can see those are gaps that we were supposed to fill, and I'll ask my husband to just put some silicone around just so it looks nicer because you can see the gap. We did a risk to take it out because I don't know how it was put in. There are no screws or anything. I think it was glued. It was something like on this side that we took out, and you can kind of see where it was because we literally couldn't make it perfect. I mean, this is just a storage room, so we left it there. My husband, I took the hooks out, my husband put it in like a little kind of concussion of things to take the rust away. So when it's done, I'm gonna put them back. If not, we're gonna buy a new one and put some hooks in there. And I want to get a shoe storage from IKEA, like the 3-level one, which is quite narrow, and we can put here like extra shoes that are out of season. And yeah, I'm very happy with this. It's all looking nice and bright, and it's just so big. I am gonna finish this vlog here, like I said. Excuse my face. I just woke up about half an hour ago and I had the coffee. We are heading to the park with the girls, so I thought I'll just leave it here. There are no major plans for this weekend, and then from next week I need to get my office sorted because I am overwhelmed by all the boxes that are in there, but I need to get it sorted. I also planned my husband's office room. That's gonna be something different from the whole house, because he is going to visit his family home, so I'll have a few days to get it all ready and make it a surprise. And yeah, I think I'm more excited to do his office than my office. I don't have any plans for mine, but yeah, that's it for this week. I hope you enjoyed this kind of mishmash of events in this video, and I'll see you in my next one. I believe you. Bye.